Amen. And the Bible talks about four lepers. The leper, those days, then, when they diagnose you, they send you out of the town, so you don't have to live
among people.
You don't have to move among people. Even when you are walking on the street, you have to make noise that a leper is coming. So you yourself will use your mouth to announce your own situation. That a worse condition is just run away. But this leper, they have been there for long. They know the situation in the city. And they know also that there are some people, the Syrian. So they have how many enemies? Huh? Do you think for 1 second that if they don't see those lepers went back home, people will be clapping that, oh, daddy has come back? Huh? So they didn't have anybody to welcome them. They began to think among themselves that, let us not die here. Tell somebody, don't die here. Don't die in your present condition. Begin to think something about it. Hallelujah. You know why what they are thinking? If you go back to the city, we are in the Second King from chapter 7 and verse 3. Hallelujah. If we go back to the city, even the people that put us in that condition, in this location, their own situation is not better. Their own situation is what?
Yes,
it's even worse. Amen? Amen? Hallelujah. And they say, okay, let's go to the camp of our enemy. Amen? Hallelujah.
Amen.
If they spare our life, we will do what? We will live. But if we kill us, we will die anyway. What is the point there? The point there is, even though they were enemy, but they have something. You know what they have? At least they have what? At least they have something that can sustain your life. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Don't always think that's when you run to your family is when you will get something great. Hallelujah. There are people out there that have something that you need.
Amen.
But if you don't go for it, you will never get it.
Sure.
Amen. So they said, let's go to this camp. At least there, we have something. They have food. But these people then, if we go over there, we just die like them. So let's move to our enemy. If they kill us, let's die. But at least we have made an effort. Amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah. Because people in this land, in this world, if you don't make an effort, you will never see God. Because you have to have faith. Like what? And the Lord will do what? He will take over. You have to make a first step, and the Lord will take you to the end. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So when they were going to the Syrian camp, what happened now? See, the camp was empty.
The camp was empty.
The enemy was not there. But the treasure was
there.
The treasure was there. Amen. Hallelujah. The enemy was not there, but the treasure was there. Gold was there. Food was there. Hallelujah. They eat and they eat and they eat and they eat. You know what? Who made the enemy run away? It was who?
God.
What happened to the enemy?
The head sounds of
chariots.
Stamping legs.
Horses.
So when they begin to move, what happened to their leg?
Begin to magnify sounds.
They begin to make it like an army. Do you know that? Despite your condition, hallelujah, you can make a city, even your situation, run away.
Amen.
If you believe.
Amen.
If you do the right thing. If you think right. You need to do what? Hallelujah. He can use what you have that you are looking like in war situation. He can use it to bring blessing into your life.
Amen.
If you believe in God.
Amen.
But if you just there lamenting about your condition, you will be there and you will die there. Hallelujah. But these people, they didn't think about death so much. They think about making what? An effort. Even with their condition. Those people that were hiding, who among them even think to go to the camp of their enemy? Huh? Who among them even think to make one step? None of them.